Hello and welcome to the main line of the classical variation. G4, knight f6, c4, e6, knight c3, bishop b4, queen c2, castles, and of course the main line is a3. We take on c3, queen takes c3, and we play d5. Why? Because in the previous videos I told you that if white goes knight f3, we go d5, because it's our part of repertoire, because it's transposition into the Rogozin defense, and then white goes h3, then we transpose to the line with a3, bishop c3, queen c3, and d5, and if now white goes knight f3. But this video is about two other moves. Both are the moves when we attack the center immediately. So let's start with bishop f4. It's a dubious move because black plays c5, and after dc, knight to c6. And white already has problems. For example, if before protecting c5 pawn, then e5 is a good move, and after bishop e5, d4, bishop f6, queen takes f6, black has lead in the development. Actually, the best move is knight f3, and it's an equality, but it's already a novelty. Knight e4, queen c2, queen a5, check, bishop d2, and queen takes c5, e3, and after knight d2, knight d2, black can take on c4 or play d4. It's just an equal position, but in the game Berkovich Borisov e3 was played, and after knight e4, that's the reason. Knight e4 is very popular in such positions. Queen c2 and queen a5 check, king e2, black should have played e5, and black already has winning position. It's and bad opening play for white. For example, bishop g3, bishop f5, or cd, just bishop f5 with the idea of playing knight g3, queen c1, ef4, bc, f takes c3, black is the devastating attack. So really bishop f4 is not playable in this position, but is playable after knight f3, b6, bishop f4, but that would be the topic of the separate video. So this video is about c takes d5. Once Magnus Carlsen played this line, and also Kramnik, but it was almost 10 years ago. So the main idea for black is to play knight e4 immediately, because white wants that black takes on d5 and then go bishop f4, e3, but no, knight e4, and white should play queen c2, because queen b3 is not great idea. He takes d5, knight f3, and like in the previous line with bishop f4, we attack the center, c5, dc, knight a6. Maybe the best move for white was queen d1, knight a takes c5 before, but then queen f6 comes, queen d4, knight b3, queen f6, knight f6, rook b1, knight c1, rook c1, bishop d7, e3, and rook f8, and black is slightly better in this endgame due to the weakness of white's queen side. But e3, it's already a dubious decision. Knight takes c5, queen d1, bishop d7, knight d4, bishop f a4. That was the problem. Queen f3 and knight b3, knight b3, and bishop b3, and white cannot protect themselves against queen a5 check. So Kiryakov, Sugirov, and black was already winning. Queen c2. E takes d5, and now bishop f4 or knight f3 or e3. Well, knight f3 is nothing because we play bishop f5 with the threat of knight g3, so queen b3 and knight c6, and black is better. E3 was played in Kramnik and Ant game, bishop f5 and bishop d3. Here black should have played queen g5, so the g2 pawn is unprotected. Let's attack this pawn. If f3, then queen h4 check, king f1, and I just ran pork, win the check because here bishop d3 is an intermediate check. In the game between two engines, white tried king f1, but here black should have point c5 with all these attacking ideas, dc and knight d7 attacking the pawn. And now before is very bad idea because knight e5, knight f3, and knight f3, g takes f3, bishop h3, king e1, queen g2, rook f1, and knight g5, and black is winning attack. So knight f3, but then black plays queen f6, and then takes knight dc5, and black is much better. So maybe the best move is g3, but that's not the best position for white. So queen g6, knight f3, and knight g3 works. Rook g1, bishop d3, queen c7. And good move. Bishop e2, rook g3, and queen a6, and white cannot castle, so black is better. Bishop f4 was the main move in this position. Knight c6 and e3. And black plays rook e8. And the threat is at some point to take on g3 with the knight and take on d4. For example, knight e2 was played in Cotanian Zhao game. But here, after bishop f5 novelty, black was much better. When d1, g5, bishop g3, h5 with h4, and if h4, then bishop g4, and the threat is to take on g3, so white position collapses. Castle Salonk is also a bad idea because bishop f5, bishop d3, and rook c8. And black just wants to take on d4 and play c5. For example, if king b1, then knight d4, ed c5, dc rook c5, queen a4, and good move rook c3. Black wants to take on d3 and to take on f2. Queen d4, rook d3, rook d3, and knight d6, bishop d6, bishop d3, queen d3, rook e1, king e2. Queen d6, and black is better because white cannot bring the rook into the game. And if f3, that was the game. Then knight d4, ed, and c5. Maybe better now was to play king b1, but after c4, bishop takes c4, d takes c4, black continues the attack, but f takes c4 was a dubious decision. D takes c4, bishop c4, cd, king b1, and bishop e6. That was Mkhitaryan against Tatiana Kosintseva game, and black was close to winning. Bishop b5 is another move, but after g5, bishop c6, b takes c6, bishop e5, c5, white is in trouble, and after knight f3, bishop f5, black was much better in one correspondence game. So the best move is knight f3, but black plays g5, and knight g3, and g4, and the only move for white is knight e5, because knight d2, knight takes d4, and black hits a pawn, knight takes e5. And maybe in this position, white can equalize with playing d takes e5. That's not an obvious move. Bishop f5 and bishop d3. Well, if you want to skip 1 or 2 minutes of this video, you can try just to go knight g3, hg, and bishop g6. But if you are an ambitious player, better move is c5. And white has some problems. f3 and queen a5 check. Maybe king f1 is a solid move. Knight g3, hg, bishop d3, queen d3, and queen a6 exchanging the queens. And end game is more or less equal. But if white wants to win a piece with b4, then comes cb, f takes e4, d takes e4. And now it's one-way ticket. Or white knows the line. Or white loses, because for example bishop e2 logical move loses after b3, queen d2, queen d2, king d2, rook e8. White really should play king e1, because if king c3, rook ac8, and b3, bishop e6, king a4, and rook d2, and black wins. So king e1, but then comes b2, very nasty move. Rook b1, rook ac8, rook f1, rook c1, king f2, rook c2, king g1, and rook dd2. The key move. F5, rook c1, rook b1, rook takes e2, e6, f6, then goes with rook c2, and this position is close to losing for white. So bishop c4 is better move, but it's not obvious if white doesn't know this line well enough. B3, queen d2, and b2, rook b1, queen d2, king d2, and now the bishop is on c4. So rook a8, we attack the bishop. Bishop b3, rook e8, king e2, and bishop b6, very strong move. Rook b2, bishop b3, rook b3, rook c2, king f1, rook d1, bishop e1, and h5. Now white rook is stuck on h1. Rook b7, h4. For example, rook a7 loses after g3, hg, hg, and black just wants to play rook f2, it's made in two moves. So e6, f takes e6, and rook b5. So now g3, rook g5, so black plays king f7, rook g5, and after rook e1, king e1, rook c1, king d2, rook h1, rook g4, rook h2. Well, black has an extra pawn, but the same game is drawish. So after c5, white is in trouble. White should really make many computerish moves not to lose. So maybe c5 is a good practical decision for black. Bishop e5 was played in some games. C5 we play. Bishop d3 and bishop f5. And now Magnus Carlsen played queen e2 and it's a mistake. But however, I already think that black's position is slightly better. For example, castles we play c4, bishop e4, bishop e4 in one correspondence game. White went queen d2, rook e6, f3, g takes f3, g takes f3, rook g6, king h1, and queen h4. White cannot take on e4 because it's a mate, so white is under pressure. Queen d1 was another correspondence game, but rook e6, king h1, rook g6, f3, g takes f3, g takes f3, and now queen g5, queen d2, and bishop f5. Well, maybe black also can try queen h4, transpose into the line we already see. Rook g1, queen h5, queen f2, f6, bishop f4, king f7, so black was better. Bishop e4 is not a solution because after bishop e4, white cannot take this pawn because bishop g2, rook g1, and bishop f3, and white is busted. So queen d1, but then queen g5, castles and c4, and we have more or less the same position. So white already has some problems, and queen e2, it's a blunder, but what to do if the position is already worse? F6, if now bishop f4, it's just loses. After queen a5, king f1, and c takes d4, and black wins immediately. If f3, g takes f3, queen f3, then c4. White cannot take queen f5 because cd, and white cannot protect against both threats. F takes e5 and queen a5. So bishop takes e4, bishop e4, queen f6, queen f6, rook f6, but rook e6, and white has many problems with the king side and with the queen side. Just look at this powerful e4 bishop. So bishop e4 was played, bishop e4, queen g4 was even worse, king h8, bishop g3, queen a5, king f1, cd, and white has no time to take this pawn because bishop d3 and rook e1 mate. So it's a bad position. So Carlsen tried bishop g3, queen a5 check, queen d2. And here Kramnik should have played queen a6, f3, g takes f3, g takes f3, bishop f3, rook f1, and bishop h5, and black is much better. Black has extra pawn, and white king is in big danger. So let's make some conclusions about both these lines. Well, I think that after bishop c4, c5, dc, knight c6, the best move for white is knight f3, and white equalizes. After cd, knight f4, queen c2, it takes d5. Well, I think that this position is already bad for white. Maybe with some good and deep analysis you can find inequality, but my personal feelings are that Black's position is slightly better. So that's all about these two moves, and in the next videos we will talk about another moves. Thanks for watching and see you again soon. Goodbye.